Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. Alright, this is going to be my third time trying to record this episode. First time being a couple days ago, second time being a couple hours ago. And I had this like huge hiatus where I was just being lazy and playing Final Fantasy X. Yes, anyways. Let us continue. I don't remember where we last left off. Oh yes. We just got beaten up.
Gorsh, there's nobody here. Sure is spooky.
We should have a Gorsh counter.
I'm not scared.
Excuse me. Did the king send you?
See, I don't know. That's not the voice I'd imagine for Aerith at all.
Come on, lazy bum. Wake up.
Hey, Kairi.
You okay?
I guess.
Those creatures that attacked you are after the Keyblade. But it's your heart they really want. Because you wield the Keyblade.
I'm so glad that you're okay, Kairi.
Kairi? Who are you talking about?
I'm the great Ninja Yuffie.
They do resemble each other.
I think you might have overdone it, Squall.
That's Leon.
The Keyblade.
Yeah, we had to get it away from you to shake off those creatures. It turns out, that's how they were tracking you.
It was the only way to conceal your heart from them. But it won't work for long. Still, hard to believe that you, of all people, are the chosen one. Well, I suppose beggars can't be choosers.
Why don't you start making sense? What's going on here?
Terrible lip syncing.
Okay, you know there are many other worlds out there besides your castle in this town, right?
Yeah.
But they're supposed to be a secret.
They've been secret because they've never been connected. Until now. When the Heartless came, everything changed.
The Heartless?
The ones who attacked you, you remember?
Those without hearts.
The darkness in people's hearts, that's what attracts them.
And there is darkness within every heart.
Hey, have you heard of someone named An-saym?
Best line coming up right now.
An-saym?
He was studying the Heartless. He recorded all of his findings in a very detailed report.
Gorsh! Can we see it?
Its pages are scattered everywhere.
Scattered?
Too many worlds.
Oh, then maybe the king went to find them.
Yes, those were my thoughts exactly.
We've got to find him, quick!
Greg! We need that key.
Breaking the fourth wall.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
Exactly.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade. That's why they'll keep coming after you, no matter what.
Well, I didn't ask for this.
The Keyblade chooses its master, and it chose you.
So, tough luck.
How did all this happen? I remember being in my room.
Wait a minute! What happened to my home? My island! Riku! Kairi!
You know what? I really don't know.
Alright. So, apparently, Squall changed his name to Leon, for whatever reason. And, there was that parallel conversation happening in the next room. Best line in the game, by the way.
An-saym?
Sort of thing. I'm probably going to be reusing that clip, and you'll see why. I never knew you could examine these things. Midday jungle, and a bald mountain at 7 a.m. What the heck is that supposed to mean? Okay, let's talk to Yuffie here. I've heard that the Keyblade can open all sorts of locks. Give it a try the next time you find a treasure chest or a door lock. Okay, why don't we try it on this one? Get on the table. Oh god, I just jumped off. Get on it. Okay. elixir, try going through this door. It's dangerous out there, don't wander out. Of course, because that's the door where Donald and Goofy are. Bringing plot convenience, let's talk to you. Sooner or later, the Heartless will find you. You'd best prepare yourself. Prepare myself? To fight for your life. Are you ready? Heck yeah, I'm ready. Yuffie, let's go join Aerith. Aerith. I don't know how to pronounce her name. She should be there by now with the other visitors. Leon!
Yuffie, go!
I like how she was pointing before the- Oh!
Yuffie!
Pain.
Sora, let's go!
Classic. Okay. Don't bother with the small fry. Find the leader. Let's go. Well, I want to bother with the small fry. Okay, so we got a new kind of Heartless here. The soldiers. The first ones we had to face are the... what are called? Shadows. And now we got these. These things give 3 points of experience each. And rightfully so, they take a lot more damage. And they're a lot more annoying. They're a lot more annoying to deal with. They just... Or maybe not, since they don't go underground or anything, so you can always hit them. Unless they're doing one of that, like, that weird spinning move that you saw right there. There we go. Like, occasionally your hits just don't work. So anyways, yeah, like I said, I tried recording this several times. The first time was a couple days ago, and I was rudely interrupted, and I had to go do something, and then I came back. It was too late, I was too tired. And it's never good to do an LP when you're tired. Let's open this chest right here. Get a potion from there. I think there's a way to get up onto the balcony here. I can't figure it out. Because I was level grinding here earlier. Oh wait, there it is. So we'll roof up right here. So yeah, basically, the encounters here, like in Kingdom Hearts, happen way more often than they do in, something like Final Fantasy X, just to put it in perspective, since that's a game I played, just yesterday, playing that, and, you know, you have to walk around for a while before you get any encounters. But the thing about Kingdom Hearts is that once you defeat all the Heartless in an area, they don't really respawn until you leave the area and wait for a while, or not even wait for a while, you have to like go several areas away, like two or three, and then you come back and then they all respawn, and there's certain like groups, like there's a single group that was on that balcony over there with the blue room, and then there should be another group that comes up here. When I just show up right here, there should be one that just a bunch of set Heartless that pop up. So that's how it's kind of different from Final Fantasy. But anyways, I'm just gonna keep fighting my way. This is also kind of puzzling to figure out because you don't really know what you should be doing. So, you know, when I first played this game, I spent like at least an hour just wandering the town before I figured out what I needed to do. Okay, can I just get these guys? Come on. Oh, great. And the soldiers dropped spirit shards. The shadows, they dropped lucid shards, and the soldiers dropped spirit shards. Man, tongue twisting myself. And recently, like, I've been having a lot of mucus and something. I've been drinking a lot more water. Like, I know I normally don't drink a lot of water, but I don't want to go to the Dalmatian's house. I go to the second district. But you can see now I'm walking, I'm not going to really encounter any Heartless since I already defeated them all in this area. But yeah, like I was saying, I'm drinking a lot more water than I normally do, so I shouldn't have this much mucus, even if I'm talking for all this time. Alright, more of these things. What was I saying? So yeah, so I don't understand why that's happening. It might be I'm getting a little bit sick. Can I just get these guys? They're just taking me down. How many hits does it take to take them out? I think it's like 6 or 7. Alright. Let's get up here. Get up. There we go. Keep forgetting that the right analog stick is not camera control. But at least you have camera control in this game. Like in Final Fantasy, where it just does whatever it wants. It's like playing Resident Evil, the original one. Then again, I'm just talking about whatever. So, you gotta go back here to the first district. It's the first thing you gotta do. What you'll notice is that the first district is a safe zone, as Leon will tell you. First district is secure. If you run into trouble, come back here. So we gotta go to the first district. Why don't we examine this now? There's another postcard in there. Alright. Let's jump back down here. And then you have to talk to Aerith. So you're the Keyblade Master. Please be careful. She gives you a Mega Potion. Well, you don't have to talk to her. You have to talk to Yuffie, I think. Yeah, here she is. Talk to her. The first district is clear, but I don't know about the third district. Well, why don't we find out? Now, that door normally leads to the third district, but it's boarded up. You can't go in there. You have to actually open it from the other side. So why don't we go there and do that? Let's clear out the third district and open the door. Let's keep jumping. Anyways. Jeez, in the throat. So today I went to a fundraising banquet for CAIR, C-A-I-R, Council on American Islamic Relations. Go there every year. This year was their 15th anniversary. So, you know, outlines their accomplishments and then they ask for money. You know, I gave a little bit, you know. Poor starving college student. I do what I can. But, whatchamacallit? There's something. Oh, yeah, they had these, like, they had really, like, fancy table decorations, but the thing that was, like, the coolest thing about them is that they had these, since they were serving chicken, they had these little mini Tabasco sauce things. And it was so weird. Because, like, it's like the bottle, it's like mini bottles. Little bottles of Tabasco sauce about the length of your pinky. And about just as wide around. So it's really funny because, like, my dad, who's kind of like a, actually he's not, like, my dad just likes to collect food and just get free stuff. So, like, when the banquet was over, my dad started just going around to a bunch of tables and just taking all the Tabasco sauce. We got, like, at least 10 of them. I'm like, really, what are you gonna do with all that? We don't even use Tabasco sauce that much. It's just gonna be another thing we keep sitting in the fridge, like those, you know, million packets of red pepper that you have from Papa John's. Okay, so you notice that the music has stopped. That means we did this right. So now let's go down. Oh, okay.
Yep. Oh. Gosh, are these the heartless guys?
Let's go get them.
Fail. The Gorsh count is now up to, I think, 5 or something. Vibration in my controller. Alright. So we've been blocked off. I don't know how the Heartless can control the geography. They never do that again. They usually provide these little invisible barriers. I do see you later. Let's take out these people. Now we have Donald and Goofy sitting by our side, or fighting by our side. And you can see that their health and magic is up there in the top right. Took them all out. No problem. Oh. Alright. Here's our first boss battle. Let's do this. Alright, so this is the guard armor. So he's got 5 parts. He's got his arms, his legs, and his feet. Goofy and Donald will heal each other. They come equipped with some potions. Okay, and the arms and legs detach from the rest of the body. So they can fight on their own, so it's kind of like fighting separate entities. but then they come together. Oh. I want to take out the arms first, instead of the easiest. So that'll just reduce the, and they're also the ones that do the most damage. Actually, I think the legs do. But the arms are easiest to destroy. If I can just attack the arms instead of the rest of it, I don't want to attack the body. Lock onto the arm. There we go. There we go. So you take out the arm. Goofy's using all of his potions on Donald because he sucks. Alright, then you want to take out the leg next. And the legs just jump around and kick you up. Just destroy one of them and you can get some health balls out of it. Health orbs. If you block them, then they're stunned for a little bit. God, I'm not really talking. Just kind of focusing on the fight. But, well, you can see there that Donald's completely knocked out. Again, being useless. Donald's not very strong when it comes to, like, health. He doesn't last very long until a few worlds later when he gets cure magic. Alright, blocked it. Now it's not going to do anything for a while. And I beat him. Wait a minute. I didn't get a level up? That's weird. So you'd expect it to like do something like crazy, like explode, but yeah, its head just falls off and releases a giant gleaming silver heart. And you obtain the Brave Warrior accessory. Has no storyline significance.
So, you were looking for me?
They too have been seeking the wielder of the Keyblade.
You guys were there and you didn't help?
Why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
I wonder if I could find Riku and Kairi.
Of course!
Are you sure?
Who knows? But we need them to come with us to help us find the thing.
Sora, go with them. Especially if you want to find your friends.
What happened to your face?
Yeah, I guess.
But you can't come along looking like that. Understand?
Ooh.
No frowning, no sad face, okay?
Yeah, you gotta look funny. Like us.
Yes, but ones like happy faces.
Happy?
That's one funny face.
This is so cheesy.
Okay, why not? I'll go with you guys.
Name's Goofy.
I'm Sora.
All for one, one for all.
Go team. Right.
That little squirt took down that heartless. Who'd have thought it? Such is the power of the Keyblade. The child's strength is not his own.
Why don't we turn him into a heartless? That'll settle things quick enough.
And the brat friends of a king's lackey. Swung on the eyes, they're all bilge rats by the look of them.
You're no prize yourself.
Shut up!
Enough! The Keyblade has chosen him. Will it be he who conquers the darkness? Or will the darkness swallow him? Either way, he could be quite useful.
Maleficent. Oh no. Anyways, that seems like a good place to stop this video. It's been about 20 minutes, and I haven't really played much at all. All I did was hang around, kill a few Heartless, and oh yeah, I beat a boss. So, that will end this video. And again, I think I'll probably make another one right after this. Or maybe not. It's like 12:30 in the morning. So maybe tomorrow. Anyways, tune in next time. See you later.